Hello everyone and welcome. Today we will demonstrate how Serviceguard can be integrated with SAP HANA system replication. The solution is set up on two HPE ProLiant DL380 servers, each with a single virtual machine acting as the cluster nodes. The VMs, called Nashville and Brentwood, form a two-node ServiceGuard cluster, with one node running the primary database package and the other running the secondary database package, which is the replicated instance of the primary database. The packages have been configured with dependencies so that they cannot run on the same node at the same time. The two packages were built using the deploy SAP packages command, but we've changed the package names from the default names to make the demo easier to follow. The screen that we'll use throughout the demo is split into four quadrants. The upper left quadrant is the SAP HANA Studio. The upper right is ServiceGuard Manager. This graphical tool is used to configure and monitor the ServiceGuard SAP cluster that we've named SAP CLUS. The lower left quadrant is a PuTTY window with the output of CMVUCL displayed in a loop. The lower right is a PuTTY window that we'll use to input commands. The refresh intervals have been turned down as low as possible in each of the tools. So HANA Studio is set to 5 seconds, ServiceGuard Manager is set to 60 seconds, and the PuTTY loop is set to 2 seconds. The HANA Studio shows all services are started for Nashville and that the HANA system replication status is green, with everything active and in sync. In the CMVUCL loop, we see that the cluster is up, with Nashville running the primary package and Brentwood running the secondary package. Data is being replicated from the primary database in Nashville to the secondary database in Brentwood. In the first scenario, we test our cluster by simulating a HANA database failure. We do this by killing the appropriate HDB daemon. Back at our active screens, we find the process ID of the HDB daemon and kill it. HANA Studio is the first system to detect the issue and reports that the database is down. In the CMVUCL window, the primary package is failing. So ServiceGuard takes the preemptive action of failing the secondary package because it has a dependency on the primary package. The secondary package halts quickly because ServiceGuard leaves the replicated database running on Brentwood. When the package is down, it goes into a relocate wait state, waiting on a node to become available. The primary package is now starting on Brentwood, and the secondary package is able to start on Nashville. During startup of the primary package on Brentwood, it detects that the secondary database was left running, and so it initiates a takeover to promote the secondary database to be the primary database. ServiceGuard Manager reports the package is starting. Back in the CMVUCL window, the primary package is up on Brentwood, and the autorun parameter is automatically set to disabled. In HANA Studio, we change the administration view to Brentwood. HANA Studio reports the database is up and running in a green state. We need to update the refresh rate in HANA Studio from the default 60 seconds to 5 seconds. ServiceGuard Manager reports the replicated instance has started. HANA Studio now reports that Brentwood is part of a HANA system replication pair, but it doesn't yet know the status of the related services. The system replication status changes to yellow, and this is better than red. This indicates that the data is not yet in sync. The status changes to green to indicate that the primary and secondary instances are now in sync. ServiceGuard reports the secondary package up and running on Nashville. It is now providing protection to Brentwood, the new primary node. Notice also that autorun is still disabled for the primary package. At this point, ServiceGuard detects that the replicated instance is in sync and automatically changes the autorun bit to enabled. This indicates that the primary database is protected and now able to fail over. Even though failover is possible because the databases are in sync, ServiceGuard has disabled switching for the primary package on Nashville because it originally failed on that node. So let's re-enable this with the cmmod package command before moving to the next scenario. In scenario one, we tested an application failure. In the second scenario, we'll show how ServiceGuard reacts to a node failure. We'll also see how ServiceGuard handles that same node rejoining the cluster. We've set the autostart CMCLD variable to 1, which allows the node to automatically rejoin the cluster after a reboot. Back at our screens, we first open vSphere and power off the Brentwood VM where the primary package is currently running. ServiceGuard detects Brentwood is missing and reforms the cluster into a single node cluster. The primary package goes immediately into a relocate wait state, as the secondary package must be shut down before the primary package can start on Nashville. The primary package is now starting on Nashville and has initiated the takeover of the secondary database. The secondary package doesn't have an available node to run on, so it is down in a failed state. HANA Studio has detected the database is unreachable and that the current status can't be determined. So let's select the Nashville tab and see that some services haven't started yet. This is an indication that the takeover isn't completed. ServiceGuard Manager has detected an issue with the cluster and will determine the current status in the next refresh. HANA Studio is updating the status of the primary database. It removed the status of the replicated instance and popped an alert that the database is not currently allowing connections. Primary database is still in the takeover status. So now Nashville is reported as green, and all daemons and services are running and available. It's not showing as a HANA system replication pair because Brentwood is not available yet. That'll be coming up next. With the primary package now up on Nashville, we can restart Brentwood. So we open vSphere to power on the VM. Brentwood is now booted and automatically rejoined the cluster. The secondary package automatically starts on Brentwood as well. ServiceGuard Manager is reporting the cluster is back up and running. And it displays a warning that the auto-run bit is disabled for the primary package on Nashville. This bit was automatically changed to disabled when the primary package detected the secondary database. When the databases are fully in sync, the autorun bit will automatically change to enabled. Looking at HANA Studio, it has detected that the secondary database is starting, but it can't determine the status of all the services yet. It does show that the two are in the process of becoming a bonded HANA system replication pair. And now reports that the secondary database is up and running and currently in the process of syncing with the primary database. ServiceGuard reports that both the primary and secondary packages are up and running. The primary package still has the autorun bit set to disabled since the sync hasn't completed yet. And now HANA Studio reports that both databases are in sync. So as soon as ServiceGuard detects this, it'll update the autorun bit for the primary package. ServiceGuard Manager is also reporting that the replicated instance is up and running. ServiceGuard detects that the replication is now in sync and changes the autorun bit back to enabled. We've demonstrated two different types of failures, at the database level and at the node level. ServiceGuard was able to get SAP HANA and HANA system replication up and running with no administrator intervention. ServiceGuard successfully managed stopping and starting of the HANA databases and the system replication. Thank you for taking the time to watch this demonstration of ServiceGuard's integration with SAP HANA system replication.